Hello, and welcome back to My Garage. Today, the Polo is back. Yes, I know, it's back again. It is German quality, at least they say that it is. But to be honest, some things just come at the same time. Like, in this case, we need to do the brakes, also the shocks. Not that the shocks are really worn, but because we did replace the front shocks, Robbie wants to replace the rear shocks as well, so that's a good thing. Oh yeah, Robin is also here. Say hi, Robin.
Hi, Robin.
He doesn't want to come in the camera view, I think, but it doesn't matter. But now we are going to do the rear brakes. And we have here my favorite brand, Zimmermann. These are zinc-coated drums. And also we have some brake shoes. And also we are going to replace the springs. Most of the time you don't have to, but I believe this kit was maybe a couple of euros, so yeah, why not? I don't know exactly why we are going to replace it all. I look at Robin, what it worn or what was the issue why we are going to replace this?
They were worn and the disc.
Oh, there was a big groove behind here, I believe, huh?
Yeah, because of
in the drums itself. Yeah.
Okay. So that's why we're gonna replace them one time.
Yeah, why did we remove the rear brakes? Oh, we just had a look. Oh yeah, that's we had a look earlier on, or I think maybe a couple of months ago. If you are going to replace the drums, replace the shoes. You don't always have to replace the drums if you're only going to replace the shoes. Does it make any sense? I think so. I believe this kit, even from Zimmermann, wasn't that expensive. I believe the shoes were about, well, maybe 20 euros or something. And a set or these were a little bit more expensive. I believe 30 euros each? 40 euros each, okay. But then again, the price was still it's just a good price for a quality brand. I do believe you can get these drums for as low as 10 or 15 euros, so maybe somewhere around 20 bucks. But yeah, enough said, let's get the stuff on the car. Yeah. We need to remove the drum first, and it's held in place just with the Torx. And this is a Torx 30 something.
Yes,
Torx 30. And it just stuck on there. So what you need to do is just give it a little bit of a tap. Oh, and don't breathe that stuff in. That's not very healthy. I'm gonna show you something what I always forget. You can, if you remember that I just hammered the old disc drum off, you don't have to do that. And I will show you the trick what I should have done. Is normally, of course, the drum is sitting right here. And what you want to do is put your screwdriver in one of these holes, and then you can just lift the auto adjuster to the top. And of course, if you adjust it to the top, it will unclamp and you can just take the whole drum off. So I don't know why I'm keeping forgetting it, but that you should have done. Of course, the other thing works if you have some leftover aggression of the week, then please go with that route. But if you're a little bit clever, then use this one. The reason why these are so hard to remove is there is just a ridge behind here. So what happens is that the brake shoe is catching on there. So that's why If you pound it a little bit with some vibrations, then you can get it off. And Robin pointed out that indeed the brake shoes are pretty worn and also deteriorate on some places. So it's not that they're completely gone, but it is a good point to replace them. The next thing what you can do is, well, remove everything and try to get it into its place as the way as you see here now. But it is much easier to do it with the bearing removed, so that's what we're going to do. Or at least Robin is going to do. I'm lazy today. Yes. The center nut is a 30-12 point socket. And then you can just take the whole assembly off. Next up, we want to remove the brake shoes. And that's pretty easy. You have to remove these clips. These clips you can press in and then just a quarter turn, you can take them off. You don't have to remove the springs or anything yet. You can try to do it, but good luck with that. So, and these come out from the back. So if you have problems with removing them, just keep your finger behind here and remove them. Now it's just a matter of getting this off. And one thing you have to be careful of is if you move this around, you have the chances are that the cups that are in place right here are going to pop off. And that's something you definitely don't want, because you then have an open system and you have definitely need to bleed the brakes. And also you have some oil all over your stuff and you have to clean, and that's something I don't like to do. So that's why we are not going to do that, at least trying to. As you can see, it's already leaking a little bit because the cup went out too far. Next up, when you want to remove the handbrake cable, and the easiest way to do that, at least what I find to do it, is use one of these C-clip pliers that can just fit between the spring right here. And then you just push the spring and then squeeze the pliers. So now you have more than enough room to hopefully wiggle that brake cable out of there. It is always a good advice to make a photo or something of the system before you remove it. Also, what you can do is, if you don't know it anymore, take off the other wheel and just have, before you remove everything, do one side first so you can look at the other side to, well, to copy that. Here we have all the parts we are going to need to install, at least at one side. Just be sure if you're going to use some new springs, there are springs for the left side and there are springs for the right side. So these are different. So be sure to check with the old springs that you remove that you use the same one and not the other one. This is the wrong one, this is the one. So this is not the spring we need, but this is the spring we need. So be sure that you do that on both sides. The things that are not included in the spring kit is this wedge. This is the automatic adjuster for the brakes and the, well, I will call it a connection beam. Yeah, that sounds about right. First, we want to install this one.
And as you can see here, there is a hook, and that hook side has to go around the lever. And then the first spring you want to use is this spring with that little Z or Z looking thing on the back. And the first thing you want to install that, let me see, into this hole, like so. And then you have to stretch it in this hole right here. So let me do that real quick. And now I'm doing it wrong. I had it in the wrong place. You have to slip it around here, and it has to go here, where that little slit is here. So, and the spring is going in this hole, this one. My bad. So this one is now in place. The thick one we don't install yet. It is for the lower half. Next one is the other one with that C, but it's a lot thicker and longer. And that one is going on the back. So the first thing you want to do is slip the other half in there. Right here. So this spring, if you turn around this whole system, this spring is going into this hole right there. You can put it in like so, and then it's sitting behind here, and it has to hook on this little latch or hook right here. Well, this is basically it, and the hardest part is now over. Before installing the lower spring, is install the brake cable first. And then try to hook the top side first. And then you can just put it into its place. Blow that. And the best thing what you can do then is install these things, because if you are trying to put the spring back on, most of the time what happens is that the brake shoes are just collapsing like so. So you have to do it all over again. And just like removing, just push them in, and just a quarter of a turn, and they stay into its place. They can be a little bit tricky. We do have special tools for this job, but I never ever thought about to buy one of those. Well, maybe now. The little wedge is going behind here. This little notch has to point away from you, so to the center of the car, and you have to put it in right here. You have to pull the shoe a little bit to the side, and then you can just slip it in there. You can do this, of course, before you're installing all this, but I like to do it the hard way sometimes, just to make myself a little bit more interesting. So, just put it on the shortest or as high as possible, and then you have this spring. And the spring connects. From here all the way down there. The next thing we want to do is do the lower spring, and you have a, you can just put it in there and stretch it over to there. Sometimes you can cheat a little bit and push these a little bit out of here. Well, one of these sliding pads came loose, so you have to put it back. So. Also, of course, you want to make sure that everything is clean before you put it back. This thing can be a really a pain to get it to its place. Get yourself one of these, that really helps, so you don't have to squeeze and pull at the same time. So now we all we have to do is pull these to the side, and most of the time with a little bit of leverage you can just push them back. And then you have to square them up a little bit so they're nice and even, so you can slip on the drum. But before that, we are just going to hose it all down with some brake cleaner. And of course you need to clean the inside of the disc drum also, so don't forget that. In the meantime that the brake cleaner is all evaporating, we're going to install the bearing. The nut has to be torqued down to 70 newton meters and then an extra 30 degrees of movement. So now it's time for the centerpiece, or the drum of course. Next up, the torque screw. And of course, don't forget the cap that goes over the bearing. So the only thing now to do is just put on the tire and of course do the other side, and then we're done. And that is how you change your rear brakes, or at least the drum brakes, on a newer model Polo. But as you have seen, I think this system is similar from, I believe, somewhere in the 80s until now. The system is almost the same. Of course, the brake shoes are a little bit different. The levers are a little bit different. It's just a little bit different, but the system is the same. So if you know one, then you can do them all. So that's a plus. See you then. It isn't that difficult. The only thing is, of course, those springs. Those springs can really be a nightmare. Just use some vise grips, or even use a bench vise. Be sure that you make some pictures before removing it. Of course, this video also helps you to locate it, but pictures is also nice to have.
So yeah, that's it. I cannot tell you any more than I already did. So that's it for today's video. I hope you enjoyed it, or at least learned something from it. And if you did, please give it a like. If you want to follow me around, you know what to do. And I will see you next time. And maybe even Robin see you next time. Say bye, Robin.
Bye, Robin.
Bye.